lecture, we see the radiative recombination, and this recombination occurs for direct band gap semiconductors. Like gallium arsenide, so if we make a energy band diagram for direct band gap semiconductor, this is maxima or top of the valence band and this is minimum of the conduction band. So in this process, electrons from the conduction band minimum falls to the top of the valence band without changing the momentum and one photon of energy h mu, which is equal to band gap of this semiconductor, is emitted. So in radiative recombination, an electron from the conduction band jumps to the valence band where it meets with a hole by radiating an energy which is equal to h mu or this band gap. So easy is this band gap. And electrons which are excited to higher energy states in the conduction band will come to the conduction band first, conduction band minimum, by releasing a energy as heat than from the conduction band minimum it falls to valence band maximum or top of the valence band by radiating of energy h mu which is again equal to band gap of this semiconductor. This type of recombination is also known as direct recombination. So if we see this statement that if an electron gets excited in higher energy state in the conduction band, then first it releases its energy in the form of heat and goes to minimum of the conduction band, and from here it falls in the conduction band and where it finds a hole. So in this way, if an electron gets excited at the minimum of the conduction band, then when it releases its energy, it will fall in the valence band by releasing this energy, which is equal to band gap of this semiconductor. And if an electron gets excited to higher energy states in the conduction band, then first this electron will lose its energy as heat, and in this way it will get a level that is very close to minimum of the conduction band, and from this minimum level it will fall in the valence band where it will find a hole and radiate its energy in the form of heat, form of photons, sorry, which is equal to the energy of this band gap. So this type of recombination is also known as direct recombination, because this recombination occurs in direct band gap semiconductors like gallium arsenide. So now we have to get some information about this direct recombination or radiative recombination, and all the information about radiative recombination can be obtained by knowing the ऑप्टिकल एब्जॉर्प्शन कोफिशियंट, अल्फा, म्यू ऑफ द सेमीकंडक्टर। सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू गेट द नॉलेज अबाउट एब्जॉर्प्शन, ऑप्टिकल एब्जॉर्प्शन कोफिशियंट ऑफ दैट सेमीकंडक्टर, एंड बाय दैट ऑब्जॉर्प्शन कोफिशियंट वी कैन गेट द rate of this radiative recombination. So if GR be the rate at which electron whole pairs generated radiatively under thermal equilibrium then this GR can be written as GR which is equal to integration of C naught alpha mu which is optical absorption coefficient P mu and D mu where C naught is the velocity of light in the semiconductor and PV or P mu or D mu is given by Planck's radiation law. So now we have to integrate this function from 0 to infinity. So by this equation we can get the generation rate at which electron hole pairs are generated, and this equation can be solved by using graph method, that is by knowing the graph of P mu with D mu we can get information about GR. Now this is about generation rate, now we have to think about recombination rate. If R be the radiative recombination rate, then it can be written as r r, which is equal to alpha r p and n, p for holes and n for electrons. And we know that at thermal equilibrium, generation rate G is always equal to recombination rate R. So therefore GR, which is equal to RR and which is equal to alpha R P note N note, and we know that at thermal equilibrium P note is equal to N note, which is equal to Ni. So we can write here P note N naught, which is equal to Ni square. So from this we can write alpha R Ni square. So from here we can get the value of Gr. So the excess carrier radiative recombination rate, if we denote it by UR, can be written as UR, which is equal to the difference of radiative recombination and radiative generation. So this is the excess carrier radiative recombination rate. By putting the value of RR and GR, we can get this rate UR as alpha R PN minus alpha R P note N note, and which can be written as alpha R. If we take alpha R as common, then this is PN minus, and we know that what is this P note N note, which is equal to Ni square. So we also note that P, which is equal to P naught plus PE and N, which is equal to N naught plus PE. So if we put these value OP and N in this equation, we can get UR, which is equal to GR by NI square. Here I am putting the value of alpha R from this equation. So which is into N naught plus P naught plus PE into PE. Now if we take reciprocal of this excess radiative recombination, we can get the radiative lifetime tau R. So from here we can get the radiative lifetime tau R is given as, that is tau R, which is reciprocal of this, that is Ni square by Gr into N naught plus P naught plus PE into PE. So this is the radiative lifetime tau R, and for strongly N-type semiconductor, with donor concentration ND we can put N naught nearly, which is nearly equal to ND, and we can also put P naught, which is nearly equal to zero. It's for heavily doped N-type semiconductor, and for low level injection lifetime can be obtained by neglecting PE in the above equation. So for heavily doped semiconductor, we can write tau R, which is equal to Ni square by Gr and Nd. So this is radiative lifetime for highly doped semiconductor. And at high level injection, P is large compared to P naught plus N naught. So therefore tau r equal to n I square by g r p e. So this is another radiative lifetime value. For example, recombination coefficient for recombination coefficient, which is alpha r, for silicon is 1.8 into 10 raised to the power minus 15 centimeter cube per centimeter cube per second. And for germanium it is 5.3 into 10 raised to the power minus 14 per centimeter cube per second. And for gallium arsenide, its value is 7.2 into 10 raised to the power minus 10 centimeter cube per centimeter cube per second. So from here we can see a large difference between the value for gallium arsenide and the silicon and germanium. So from here we can see that the indirect band gap semiconductor like silicon and germanium a low value of recombination coefficient is available. Therefore, the radiative lifetime in this semiconductor. Is several orders of magnitude higher than the measured lifetime. For example, in silicon doped with 10 raised to the power 15 donors per centimeter cube, the lifetime calculated from above equation is 0.56 seconds, whereas the measured value may range from a fraction of second from a fraction of millisecond to a few microsecond. Thus, radiative recombination remains insignificant in these semiconductors. And lifetime is controlled by indirect recombination. Via localized impurity states in the band gap. And it is worth to note that both GR and NI square increase with temperature, increase with increase in temperature. However, GR is more sensitive to temperature variations than Ni square. Consequently, the radiative lifetime is a slowly decreasing function of temperature. Meaning is that as we see the equation for tau, we can see that here Ni GR is more sensitive than Ni square. So as we increase the temperature, tau will slowly decrease. So in this lecture, we see what is radiative recombination and how can we determine radiative lifetime for semiconductors. And by knowing that lifetime, we can see that how this lifetime can vary in direct and indirect bandgap semiconductors.